Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Watch It Wednesdays. This week's episode is dedicated solely to the males. Yes, we'll be assisting them in putting together a formal business attire for an interview. Today we'll be exploring all the do's and don'ts that men should think of when putting together their attire for an interview. We often think that it's easy for men to get dressed, but no, just like us females, they tend to get nervous and frustrated, especially if they have never ever had to do a formal interview. So we will be guiding them today. Now guys, remember, no matter what job you're interviewing for, it could be at a construction company, it could be in a corporate office, in a bank, for a garbage collection company, it is extremely important to be well put together, to be neat, to be tidy. Yes, it's okay to show some personality in your attire, but as I said to the females, leave out the loud clothing. Avoid the socks and the ties that have a lot of busy images and patterns on them, characters, the belts with the big buckles, the extremely broad belts, the oversized belt buckles, leave those alone. Extremely tight shirt, tight pants that fall below the waist, try to avoid those. So, as I said before, today we'll be going through some practical ideas on how to get dressed and put together an attire that is appropriate and will be well received at your interview. If you chose to wear a suit, which is always preferable, wear a single-breasted two-piece suit in dark color. No burgundy, no mustard, no cream, no, leave those for weddings and church outings and other outings. But for your interview, ensure that your suit is standard, solid color. Make sure it's properly tailored, it's well fitting on the shoulders. Ensure that it's not overly baggy or overly tight. See on screen, I have an example. And of course, you know, you can go to your tailor and you can search to find suits that are very appropriate. Ensure the suit, as I said, if it's gonna have any design, the pinstripes are so small that they're hardly visible. The shirt that you wear underneath your suit should be of light quality. As I was saying, the shirt that you choose to wear should be of light color. Shouldn't have a lot of patterns or any busy geometric designs that make it seem as if you're on a Caribbean or Hawaiian vacation. To complement your suit and your shirt, have an appropriate tie. Again, a solid color or simply lines, no overly geometric designs, no characters, no busyness. Stay away from the loudness. You don't want to have an outfit that makes you look comical. Here we have another example of a suit that is quite fitted and well tailored. However, it would have been very nice if this person had worn a tie, but depending on where you're interviewing, you may be able to get by without wearing a tie. For example, if you're in the IT industry, they are not so strict on you being business formal. So you can slide by without wearing a tie, but a lovely button-down shirt underneath your jacket or blazer. As it relates to your shoes, wear a dark shoes, whether a shoe of dark tone, whether it's black or brown. Ensure that they are polished and free of scratches and stains. Make sure they are well put together, they look good. Ensure also that your shoe match your belt. So whatever color shoe or tone shoe you wear, ensure that the belt is of the same color or same tone. As I had said at the start of this clip, ensure that your belt doesn't have those big oversized buckles that are shiny and just loud. You just need a regular belt that you can find in any men's department at a general store. Very importantly, do not wear loafers, sneakers, slippers, flip-flops, whether they are the cushy, comfortable brand name ones. It doesn't matter how expensive they are, as long as they are not closed formal shoes, don't wear them. See the loafers that we have on screen here are boat shoes. That is not acceptable. Gentlemen, remember your socks. Even if you're not a lover of socks, wear good socks. And we're trying to find socks that are plain, even if they have some geometrics. Again, do not make it overly dizzy and pretty to be distracting. While I have this picture on screen, let me hasten to say, do not wear jeans to an interview. Jeans, whether it is expensive Tommy Hilfiger, whether it's Lee's, it no matter the brand, it no matter how fitted, it no matter how worn, no matter how new, jeans are not appropriate for an interview, especially a business formal interview. It's a definitely no. Likewise, wearing these attire that I have on screen here, folded shirt sleeve, folded or cuff pants sleeve, white sneakers, yes, it's Gucci. See this pants with geometric design, no belt. Yes, they may look good. They may be appropriate for, as I said, Friday casual in the office or an office party, or if you're in the IT industry or something. But I would not recommend these outfits, inclusive of shorts, although there's not any here, to be worn to a formal interview. Save this for when you get the job and you want to show it on your Friday for casual day at the office. Now, if you have to take a copy of your resume and cover letter, don't just walk with them in your hand folded in an envelope or a paper jacket or a file jacket. Get a nice laptop bag or a leather case or something that shows that you are a serious candidate at the interview. So this gentleman here, he looks very smart and smashing with his laptop case or his portfolio case. Here is also an example of a satchel that you can take. It's a nice leather bound bag, or it doesn't have to be genuine leather, but just a nice bag that can hold all your required documents. Now, as it relates to grooming, guys, ensure that your hair is washed, it's properly trimmed, neatly lined up, there are no designs in your hair, it is properly brushed or combed, and for heaven's sake, no braids, no cornrows. If you have long hair or locks, tie neatly behind, groom it and have it neatly tied behind. Please, don't give your prospective employer a reason to immediately disqualify you, because you know people do judge. They judge, so you cannot give them a reason to judge you before you present your best self. This is a touchy area, but we have to go there. Please ensure that you bathe properly. Wear good deodorant. Do not wear colognes that are overly strong. It can be very distracting, and it can irritate your interviewer's sinus, and you don't want them to ask you to leave the room because everybody's sneezing. So ensure that you wear a cologne that is calm to the nostril. Also, ensure that your nails, your fingernails, they are properly cleaned and cut, especially if you're doing an interview for the hospitality industry. You can't afford to have nails that are long and dirty. I know men tend to have great pride in having long nails and all of that, but for an interview, it's a definite no-no. Ensure that they are properly cleaned and cut. And very importantly, if you have a tattoo, ensure that it is covered up. If it's a visible tattoo in an area that everybody can see, cover it up. If you are wearing piercings, whether it's in your ears, your nose, wherever, because you know males do wear piercings, again, take them out. As I said earlier, we do judge. Your employers will judge you, and based on your attire, which is one of the first things that they are seeing about you outside the interview, So you need to ensure that those piercings and tattoos are hidden, because trust me, you can lose a job based on that. And I've heard of stories, incidents of persons being fully qualified based on their academic achievements, their resume, their cover letter. They easily could have gotten a job, but because they had a lot of tattoos that were visible and piercings, they were deemed to not be a good fit for that particular job environment. So again, please cover them, take them out. Okay guys, I hope I've given you enough tips, I've given you enough ideas, we have covered enough material on how to prepare your attire for your next interview. Now, as I always say, the internet, the web has a variety of ideas it relates to styling. So you can either go to my beloved Pinterest, you can go on some of the IG pages, you have YouTube pages, Facebook pages, even Google itself. Just Google what to wear or not to wear to a formal interview, and you'll get tons of ideas on how to dress and be confident for your next interview. So now that we have covered both the males and females as it relates to putting together an appropriate business formal attire for an interview, I hope you can start searching. Because remember, your mock interview is coming up and we'll be looking for ideas that we spoke to you about in these videos. Remember, first impressions are lasting, and it's always best to put your best foot forward. Toodles, until next time. Bye.